my little baby. Change your bracelet. That's a hook break. On the watch that. Yeah, I'm on work. If you want that.
Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be a review on this wig that I'm wearing right now. Y'all, I am loving this wig. This curl pattern is so effing balmy, guys. Like, oh my god, like I'm just loving it. And then just like how natural it looks, like I'm living for this hair, you guys. If you guys see me looking down at my phone, I just have my notes on my phone on what I want to touch on for this review. Before we get started on this review, I just want to say thank you guys. I feel like I don't say thank you enough. So I just wanted to take this moment to say thank you guys for supporting me. Thank you guys for continuously watching my videos and liking my videos and all that good stuff. I really do appreciate it. Without you guys, this wouldn't be your job at the end of the day. You know what I mean? So I just want to thank you guys for supporting me and all that good stuff. Anyways, let's just hop right into this video. So this wig was sent to me by Coco Black Hair. This is my first time working with this company. They reached out to me a few months ago, asking to see if I would like to collab. And you guys know I'm always open to collabing with different hair companies. I'm always open to trying out different wigs, different styles of wigs, different colors. You guys already know I switch up my hair like all the freaking time. If you guys wanna know the specifics about this hair, I will leave all the information in the information box down below. But I do wanna say that, number one, this is a 360 wig, and you guys already know that I really love my 360 wigs, just because you can part it however you want, and you're not like limited, you know what I mean? So this is a 360 wig, which I really love. And then I just wanted to tell you guys how many inches this wig is, but everything else is gonna be down below. So this is a 24 inch wig. You guys already know I love my super long wig. I'm just gonna stand up so you guys can see where the hair falls on me. I am 5'3", so if you guys are around, just to kind of give you an idea of like what length to choose, what would be good for you, I wanna stand up to show you guys where it falls on me. So I stand up, it's 24 inches. So it falls like, I guess just below my boob area. If you guys can see, you guys look how bomb this freaking curl pattern is, like so freaking cute. You guys already know I love super duper duper quadruple thick hair, and y'all, this hair is freaking thick. Some of you guys may be thinking like, oh wow, that's not really long for 24 inches, but you guys gotta remember that it is curly hair. Of course, if it's straight hair, it's going to fall a lot longer, but because it's curly, curly hair does shrivel up, so it's gonna seem shorter than 24 inches, but of course, when you guys pull on the curl, it is gonna get long. Let's just go into what my dislikes are first, and then we can move into like what my likes are. I don't really have a long list of dislikes, but there's two things. First thing that I noticed about the hair is that it does shed a little bit. It is curly hair, so I guess that is to be expected. It's not like a crazy amount of shedding. It's something that is definitely tolerable. It's a little bit more high maintenance, so you're gonna have to kind of detangle it. It's not one of those things where you could just like wake up and go. Because the hair does hold a super tight curl, you do have to take some time to detangle it because you don't want it to get matte. I haven't experienced any matting yet because I did detangle it. Second thing is I felt like the wig cap was a little too small for my head. I wish it were just a tad bit bigger. Usually when I choose my wig cap construction size or whatever, I usually am an average. In regards to that, I would just say be a little bit cautious to maybe go like a size up, because you do have the option to choose the different sizing, which is really cool. Let's now move into the likes about the hair. Now this list is way longer than the dislikes, but first thing I do want to say, the hair is extremely thick, and as I stated before, that's something that I really really look for. And sorry guys, I don't know if you guys noticed or not, but I did break my nail. I was like at work and I was like trying to clean like my makeup brush, and I don't know, and I literally just got these done, and I'm so mad because I just got them done and they broke. I hate when that happens. But yeah, anyways, so this hair is really thick, and that's one of the things that that's probably like the number one thing that I love about this hair. Number two, I feel like the hair, I'm not sure if it's stated on, I would have to like go back and check. I don't know if it's stated on this particular wig if the hairline was pre-plucked. But if it was not, this hair, I did like a little bit of plucking, but I really didn't have to go in like I usually do with a lot of my wigs, because the hair was actually not super crazy thick along the edges. It was actually, it seemed as if it was already pre-plucked. It very well could have been pre-plucked. I don't remember if it stated that or not, like on the website. But yeah, I thought, listen, when wigs are sent to me that are already kind of bleached and plucked and all that good stuff, it just makes my life a lot easier where I don't have to go in and do like a whole bunch of work. But yeah, so I like that the hairline was already like thin. That's something that's really important in making your wigs natural, is having a thin hairline, because that's how our hair naturally is. It's thin at the hairline and then of course it gets thicker and thicker. I did bleach the hair, and that's something that I have to do with pretty much all my wigs. It's very rare that a wig will come already pre-bleached, but it's not a big deal to me. Like, I do it all the time. Just to let you guys know, there are 3 combs that come in this wig, which are very convenient if you guys do not want to glue the hair. There's 2 on the side and then 1 on the top, so you guys honestly, sorry, that's just my phone. So you guys honestly just kind of have to, like, you know, slide the 2 combs in on the side and then slide it on top, and just make sure that it fits comfortably on your head, and you guys are pretty much good to go. One of the things that I do want to touch on is the texture of the hair. This is one of the biggest reasons why I chose this particular style, is that I wanted something that was, I've never tried a wig that was this particular curl pattern. I wanted something that'll look like my natural hair, something that resembles black hair, and I feel like it's kind of like the texture of it, it's not silky. I do want to let you guys know that it's not like a silky kind of like texture. It's more like, it's very, very soft, but I feel like it kind of has a little bit of a coarseness to it. I don't know really how to like say that, but it's very soft, but it has a little bit of coarseness to it. But I like that, because for someone who's looking for like curly hair that resembles black hair, this would definitely be a really good wig to choose from. Like, literally, this is probably the same like hair type as my natural hair. Like, I would say that my natural hair is like a 3C 4A, you know, I think that, I don't know, I'm not like I'm not like a pro when it comes to like the type of curl pattern you have, but I would say that my curl pattern definitely resembles this, so it's really cool that I could find something that looks realistic. Like, if I walked outside, people would think like, oh, this is my natural hair. And if you guys are wondering what I use to style this hair, I use this curling mousse. I think it's called Cream of Nature. It's a red bottle. I got it from like Target for like, I don't know, like $7 or something like that. So what I did was I just got a spray bottle and I wet the whole hair, and then I put a lot of mousse on my hand and I kind of just, you know, combed it through my hair, and then I took like a paddle brush and then just like detangled it and combed it and make sure that all the mousse got all inside, and then I just went and scrunched the hair. You don't necessarily need to scrunch the hair because the hair is already like super curly, but I just went in and scrunched the hair a little bit and then I just let it air dry. So this is what it looks. And you guys, another thing too, this hair took like all of like 20 minutes to dry completely. The hair is gonna get, if you guys want something that is even more thicker than this, all you guys have to do is kind of like comb it and tease it out. I don't want the hair to get too big, so I'm actually fine with the way that it looks now. But if I did want it to get bigger, all I would have to do is kind of like shake it up, kind of like break it apart a little bit, and it would get even bigger. So y'all have like some Beyonce hair, you know what I mean? So that pretty much completes my thoughts on, you hear me getting my New York accent? But yeah, that pretty much completes my thoughts on this wig. Make sure you guys thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. And I will be back to do, oops. And yeah, I will be back to do more videos in the upcoming weeks. I know I've been doing a lot of hair reviews lately. I just haven't been in my creative space to do like makeup tutorials that I used to do. I know that's kind of what I started my YouTube off of, was doing makeup tutorials. And I know I've been seeing you guys, even if I don't respond to all of you guys' comments, I know that I do read and go through all of them. And I do see you guys' comments on, you know, when I'm gonna do a makeup tutorial. So that is definitely something that I want to kind of you know, move into in the next couple weeks is starting to do more makeup tutorials and having a really good balance, a good balance between makeup and hair tutorials. But yeah, you guys, I definitely do see your comments, and that is something that I wanted to get into myself for a really long time. I just kind of haven't found the time because I do have a full-time job. So I'm just trying to like balance everything, but that's something that, you guys, I am looking forward to doing on this channel, is more makeup tutorials and then also more vlogs as well. That's another thing that I've been seeing you guys, you know, comment, is for me to do more vlogs. So those are two things that, you know, as we go into the next year, that's something I definitely want to create more on this channel. It's not just strictly hair tutorials, but doing kind of like an overall, you know, just like a lifestyle channel. But yeah, anyways, you guys, I love you guys so much. Thank you for all the support, and I will see you guys next time.